Ever wondered about the difference between lactic acid and glycolic acid? Both are powerful exfoliants, but they have distinct characteristics that make them better suited for different skin types and concerns. So if you're wondering which one would be better suited for you and which one to go with, this video is just for you. Also guys, give this video a like and subscribe down below so you don't miss out on future videos. I talk extensively about evidence-based ways to improve your hair, skin, and health. So if that's something you're into, definitely consider subscribing. I'll make this video short and straight to the point just in case you're ready to choose between the two and you're at the aisle checking out. But before we get into that, let's talk about how these two are different. Lactic acid is derived from milk and other fermented products. It has a long history of use in skincare. Cleopatra's use of sour milk baths is one of the most famous examples. Lactic acid is part of the alpha hydroxy acid family, known for its ability to exfoliate the skin, right? Same with glycolic acid. These are both AHAs. Both are going to exfoliate the skin, but the key difference is that lactic acid has a larger molecular structure compared to other AHAs, which limits its penetration into the skin and makes it a milder exfoliant. And this is the big takeaway. It's a lot milder because of its size. But beyond exfoliating, does lactic acid do anything else? Well, yes, it's also a humectant at the same time, which means it attracts moisture from the environment into the skin, which can improve skin texture and radiance without irritation. Glycolic acid, on the other hand, is derived from sugarcane. And is another one of those widely used AHAs in skincare due to its efficacy in addressing a variety of skin concerns. And this is because of its molecular size being one of the smallest ones. This means it's able to penetrate the skin more deeply, unlike lactic acid. And the further down into the skin it could go, the more things it can do. A big one being its ability to accelerate skin cell turnover, which helps to remove the top layer of skin cells and stimulate the growth of new skin cells. While it's able to go down there, it can also address other skin concerns too, like hyperpigmentation, fine lines, and acne, which makes it a popular choice in anti-aging and acne-fighting products. So that sums up the key differences. Let's now talk briefly about how each works on the skin. Lactic acid primarily works on the outermost layer of the skin, known as the stratum corneum. It breaks down the bonds between skin cells, allowing them to shed more easily and revealing fresher, brighter skin underneath. And guys, remember, because lactic acid molecules are larger, they aren't going to penetrate as deeply into the skin. The benefit of that is that it reduces the risk of irritation. So keep that in mind as you're about to purchase. It's going to be a great choice for those who have sensitive skin or conditions like rosacea. Glycolic acid, which has the smallest molecular size among AHAs, allows it to penetrate deeper into the skin layers, specifically reaching the dermis. Because it goes deeper into the skin, this makes it more effective at stimulating fibroblasts to accelerate collagen production, which can reduce the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles. This fact here alone can help you determine which one you want to go with. Now let's talk about who should use lactic acid. There are four kinds of people who will benefit the most from lactic acid. Let's see if you fit into any one of them. The first is if you have very sensitive skin. If you constantly struggle with redness from products, irritation, and inflammation, lactic acid's gentle nature makes it an excellent choice for you because you can get the exfoliating benefits without stripping the skin or causing further irritation. The second group to benefit from lactic acid is maybe, let's say that you don't have a sensitive skin, but you have dry skin, or for that matter, sensitive skin that is also dry and you need some type of exfoliant. Lactic acid can be a good choice here too because it has a humectant property which will help to draw moisture in. Great if you have flaky and tight skin. The other group is if you have aging skin, because as we age, our skin tends to become thinner and more sensitive, right? Lactic acid is less likely to irritate the skin while still providing the exfoliation that you need to get that skin cell turnover. And the last group to really benefit from lactic acid is if you're a beginner to exfoliation. If you're new to chemical exfoliants and you want to start your journey, then start your journey with something mild like lactic acid. It's a good starting point for anyone who wants AHA benefits without the risk of over-exfoliating. Now let's talk about who should use glycolic acid. The first group of people who will benefit from it are oily and acne-prone skin types. This is because it can go deeper into the skin and unclog pores, reduce the appearance of acne scars, and even control excess oil production. So if you're in that boat, glycolic acid would better suit you. The second group is those who have hyperpigmentation and dark spots. Its deep exfoliation helps to fade discoloration by removing the pigmented cells and promoting the growth of new even-toned skin. It also inhibits tyrosinase, which is the enzyme responsible for melanin production. The third group to benefit is if you have fine lines and wrinkles. This is because glycolic acid stimulates collagen production, which can plump the skin and smooth out the signs of aging. And fourthly, if you're already an experienced user of chemical exfoliants, those who have already used milder acids like lactic acid or salicylic acid and are looking for stronger treatments will benefit from glycolic acid. However, with that said, it's important to introduce it slowly to avoid irritation. Let's talk about products now. What lactic acid should you go with? You want formulations that won't dry out the skin. For example, you could go with the Biossance Squalane and Lactic Acid Resurfacing Night Serum. Not sponsored, but you can pick it up down below as my affiliate should you wish to try it out. I've been a fan of Biossance because they are known for their commitment to clean beauty. There are no parabens, phthalates, synthetic fragrances, or mineral oils. This makes it a safer choice for long-term use. It has a 10% vegan lactic acid, which is an optimal concentration for effective exfoliation without being overly harsh. And also you get the squalane, which will provide even deeper hydration. And in terms of what glycolic acid to go with, a lot of people think that the Ordinary is the best for their glycolic acid. However, I think that the glycolic B5 serum by the Roche-Posay is better, and no, this isn't sponsored either. But if you're looking at really targeting discoloration as well as getting all the other benefits of glycolic acid, this one contains tranexamic acid and kojic acid as well as vitamin B5 to really target the dark spots and hydrate the skin. It's also great for sensitive skin too. And the best way to use each of these would be 2 to 3 times a week to see how your skin reacts. This allows you to monitor for any signs of irritation, such as redness or peeling. If your skin tolerates it well, you could then gradually increase usage to every other night or even nightly, depending on your skin's needs and tolerance. I'll leave both serums for you down in the description below. I know some of you guys will ask, can you combine lactic acid and glycolic acid together? You certainly can, but you need a formulation that also contains soothing ingredients alongside it in order for the skin to best tolerate the combination and not damage the skin barrier. One that I like is the Cerave Skin Renewing Nightly Exfoliating Treatment, for example. This is a good solution. It's gonna give you the lactic acid benefits and give you the glycolic acid benefits at the same time. The formulation also pairs it with tons of ceramides and licorice root extract to make sure that the skin does not get irritated along the way and supports the skin barrier at the same time. Also, not to forget to mention, it's non-comedogenic, paraben-free, fragrance-free, and most importantly, suitable for all skin types. And bonus if you're struggling with milia. This product can definitely be a game changer for some of you folks. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys now. Which AHAs are you currently using? What are the current skin struggles you're facing? We'd love to hear your feedback down below. And if you found this video helpful, click on the subscribe button down below. And until then, guys, watch this video about black seed oil for aging skin, and I'll see you on the next one.